You will find the current of a circuit using Norton's theorem. So that is the given circuit with voltage source 10 volt and resistors 3, 6, 3 and 5 ohm. Here this 5 ohm is the load resistor and we have to find the current through this 5 ohm resistor. Now the first step is to find the Norton current. Now to find the Norton current, we have to short the load resistor of this circuit. So short this load resistor in this case. Now we will redraw the circuit after shorting the load resistor. And all the other components of the circuit will be same. So that is shorted. That is 3 ohm, 6 ohm. That is 3 ohm. Now we have to find the short circuit current along this loop. Okay, so to find this current, we have to find the total current of this circuit generated by this 10 volt source. So first of all, we can see that there this 6 ohm and this 3 ohm are in parallel connection. So we can replace them with a single resistor. So that is 10 volt battery, 3 ohm resistor, and the new resistor, that is a parallel combination of 6 and 3, and it has a value like 6 into 3 divided by 6 plus 3, that's equals to 2 ohm. Okay, now you can find the total current of this circuit. So that is the total current is given by I1, that's equals to total voltage divided by total resistor, that is 3 plus 2. So that's equals to 10 by 5, that's equals to 2 ampere. Now we get the total current of the circuit. So you can see that this 2 ampere current is generated by this 10 volt along this way, and after reaching at this point, this current will be divided in two direction, and we have to find the current in this loop. So here we have to use the current divider rule. So using current divider rule, the current through this loop will be I1 prime, that's equals to I1 into other resistor, that is 6 ohm, divided by sum of the two resistors, that is 6 plus 3. So here I1 is 2 ampere into 6 divided by 9, that's equals to 4 by 3 ampere. Thus we get current through this loop. Now this is the short circuit current and this is called the Norton current. Okay, that is 4 by 3 ampere. Now the second step is to find the Norton resistance, and that is same with the Thevenin resistance. So for this we have to short the voltage source and remove the load resistor. So just short the source and leave the other components as usual and remove the load. Okay, so that is 3 3 6, and the resistance across this terminal is called Thevenin or Norton resistance. So here this 3 and 6 are in parallel connection, so the equivalent resistance will be replaced by them. So that is 3, and the equivalent resistance of 6 and 3 is given by 6 into 3 divided by 6 plus 3, that's equals to 2. So that is 2 ohm, and here appearing the Norton or Thevenin resistance. Okay, now this 3 and 2 ohm resistor are in series connection, so we can replace them with a single resistor, that is like this, and that is the Thevenin or Norton resistance, and this is 5 ohm. And now we can say that the value of Norton resistance is 5 ohm. Okay, now the third step is to draw the Norton equivalent circuit, that is a current source with a parallel Norton resistor, that is current source with current Norton current, that is Norton resistor Rn with the parallel connection of load resistor, that is RL. Now already we have found the value of In, that is 4/3 ampere. The value of Norton resistance is 5 ohm and the value of load resistor is given in the problem, that is also 5 ohm. Ohm. Now you can see that the total current in this circuit is distributed in this two part. That is 4/3 ampere current is total current. Now at this point it will be distributed in two branches. And you have to find the current through this load resistor. And you can see that both the resistance have the same value, 5 ohm. So this total current will be divided in two parts equally. So current in each branch would be half. So that is 2/3 ampere. Thus we get the load current through the circuit, that is IL, that is given by 2/3 ampere.